Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is part of the Unify Access range. This is the UA-Hub-Gate. This varies slightly to some of the other access hubs, so we'll talk about that a little bit in this video, but it's not meant to be a big technical overview. You can see a little bit more of that over on our YouTube channel. We've got some deep dives and how-to guides on there. But let's get into what you actually get in the box. So to start with, on the inside of the box, we're going to get some screws and lugs because this can be wall mounted. How do you wall mount it? You're going to use the DIN rail. Screws are going to go through this rail if you've not already got a DIN rail in place. And then on the back here, you can actually see this has got some fitting grooves. So you're going to push that up, push it into place. And obviously that allows you to then mount that on the wall like that. So let me just take that off. So that's your mounting option for the wall. You are then obviously going to get a little, let's call it a get started guide, a QR code to link you to Ubiquiti's website. And just a reminder on here that this is a PoE powered device. I'll talk about a little bit more about that in a moment. So a little reminder on there. And you're going to get a conformity guide, which you may not even take out of the wrapping, but it's in there. Then you're going to get the device itself. Like I said, this is a PoE powered device. You can't connect this directly, or you can't connect any of the Ubiquiti access devices directly to a switch. The switch needs to connect to a hub. This is the inside, this is the workings. And generally you need one of these per door. Now this is very slightly different, which we'll talk about in a moment. This can actually control two doors or gates and a door. I'll talk about that in a moment. So you've got over here your PoE in over on this side. And then we've got four PoE ports across the top here. It takes PoE++. You maybe have some of your cameras if you want to do license plate recognition, because this is a gate opening hub. You may have an intercom connected to here or just some normal readers. On the back, really, like we said, it's like this. On the front here, so we have a number of terminals. These ones in gray here are all dry contacts, meaning they don't actually supply any power. So these are for two gate openers. And then down here is for a side gate. Then you have some various options on this side for exits and sirens and capture areas. And there's a few other bits you can see about, obviously, if you're doing automatic number plate recognition and what happens if a gate partially opens when a vehicle's part of the way through and those types of things. So they are very definite in how they want to be wired up. But I want to just talk about these key here. So this can be wired in a couple of ways. You maybe have got one gate, maybe a boom gate, or maybe a sliding gate or a normal opener. You would maybe just have one of these. So this is going to connect out to your already installed gate equipment, which will just have a on-off or open-close set of buttons or terminals for you to wire to. No voltage will be provided to this to make the action happen, but you would maybe wire to your already placed gate installation to make the opening work. Maybe you've got two boom gates and then you would you have both of these wired to that opener, and then that would work those as well. The interesting thing on this one here is we have this side gate. So these two here operate as one, if you like, depending on how the wiring's done, but in the controller is seen as one device or one gate, and this is here seen as another gate. So this, like I said, doesn't provide any power. This one provides 12 volts. You can do that to a normal door strike or something like that as well. So in theory, this can work with a gate, or if you maybe had another door and the door already had a power source, you can't wire this in line so that this becomes the sort of the actual physical switch to break the physical circuit. But if you've got a door opener in place that has power in and then has a separate set of terminals to do the activation of the open or the close, then you could theoretically do two separate doors on here and not just gates. So this does have some options, but remember, really all of this is the guts, the heart of making this work. The rest of this is really down to you, your electrician, how these terminals can be wired. Like we said, we've got siren options, emergency options. We've got an auxiliary over here that, again, if it was secondary powered, theoretically, you might be able to do another opening over here. And we've got exit buttons as well. So this is the heart of everything. This has to be connected with a PoE to a PoE switch, and then you do need a controller. Remember, you need an Ubiquiti OS console, a UCG Max, a UDM Pro, or something like that to actually control it. So you can see, like I said, we've got the indicator lights on here. We've got our two boom gates or slide gate openers here that are dry, no power. And we've got an option down here for a powered opener as well, which is what makes this slightly different to the hub door, which is the standard one of these that has also four PoEs across the top. So hopefully that's been useful. There's a few different ways maybe you've got your mind going on how you could use that. We do have some deep dives, like I said, on how to set up Unify Access, some options of how this appears and how to set this up also over on our YouTube channel. So why don't you head over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.